Today, we are going to investigate these three absolute-value equations and notice that they all have the same two absolute-values on the left-hand side, but on the right-hand side, we have 1, 1 half, and 2. So what's going on? Well, let's have a look at the first one. Absolute value of x minus 2 plus absolute value of x minus 3 is equal to 1. Of course, we can take away the absolute value, but we will have to break down two cases and then just solve it algebraically. I'm going to leave that to you. It will be better in this situation to use the definition of absolute value to help us out. So I'm just going to give you guys a short example first. So here is a note. For example, if we are looking at just x minus 2 in the absolute value, if this is equal to 1, a much better way is to understand what's going on. Here, x minus 2, that means we're trying to get the distance between x and 2 being equal to 1. So if you look at the number line, let's say 2 is right here. And now, you want the distance to be 1. So where is x? You can start with 2, move to the right one time, and you end up with 3. So x could be equal to 3. But you can also go to the left one time, but remember, we are talking about the distance. So distance here is 1. Likewise, the distance here is also 1. But if you go to the left, it's 2 minus 1 is 1. So the equation right here, we will have x equals 1 and 3 for the solution. All right, now for this right here though, notice we have x minus 2 and also x minus 3. So we want the distance between, let me draw this right here, let's say 2 is right here and 3 is right here. We want the distance between x and 2 and then add up the distance between x and 3 is equal to 1. But what's so special about the 1? Well, the 1 happens to be the distance between 2 and 3. So where can x be? Let's just think about it. If we put the x right here, well, this distance is going to be, I don't know, like 0.5 or something, right? Like a little bit, some small number. But if you look at the distance between x and 3, this much is 1 already. So it will be definitely more than 1. It doesn't make sense. Likewise, x cannot also be here either. Otherwise, the distance between x and 2, it will be more than 1 already. So not possible here, not possible here. So where is the possibility? It has to be somewhere in between, right? So now have a look. Let's say that's x. This measures the distance between x and 2. And then this measures the distance between x and 3. Hey, I don't know how big this is, I don't know how big that is, but I know together they add up to be 1. In fact, we could have picked x somewhere right here as well. Then you see the distance between here and here, and the distance between here and here. Once again, they have to add up to be 1. So, that's a trick for this question. In fact, we have infinitely many solutions. The answers for this equation is that we have any x in between 2 and 3, including the endpoints. Right? So that's the first one. Now for the second one, we have 1 half. So what do we do with this? Well, in fact, this equation has no solution. Let's take a look at the picture again. So we have the 2 here and then the 3 here. Now, where can we put the x? If I put the x here, then the distance between this x and the 3 is already bigger than 1, plus whatever that is, can never be equal to 1 half. Likewise, if we put the x right here, again, same reason, not possible. If it's x somewhere in between, well, the distance between this and that and this and that, it's exactly equal to 1. It's not 1 half. So anything less than 1, the equation has no solution. Now for the last one, we have 2 right here. And because this is bigger than 1, we are going to have. Now for the last one, we have 2 right here. And for this equation, we have exactly 2 solutions. Now let's have a look. Here's the picture. Here we have the 2, and here we have the 3. Where do you put the x? Not in between anymore, but rather, let's consider the x right here first. Absolute value of x minus 2 is this distance right between x and 2. And then we are going to add the absolute value of x minus 3, which is this distance from here all the way to 3. So now let's just look at the picture and see what we need to do. From 2 to 3, that's equal to 1. And from x to 2, or 2 to x, that distance based on the picture is 2 minus x, right? Because 2 is bigger than x on the picture, because x is on the left of 2. Notice this portion is actually counted twice, because we have the first part from here, and then the second part also includes this. So this equation can be narrowed down to 2 times 2 minus x, and then plus 1, and make that equal to 2. And now we just have to solve that. So work this out. 2 times 2 is 4 minus 2x plus 1 is equal to 2. And then that is 5 minus 5 on both sides. Negative 2x is equal to negative 3. Divide negative 2 on both sides. X is equal to positive 3 over 2. And that's the first solution. Now for the second solution, it will be somewhere here. Somewhere here. Okay, we are going to do exactly what we did. This portion is 1, and this portion here will be x minus 3. And remember, we will also have to go, that's the first part for this, and then the second part for that is this. So this has to be counted twice. We have 2 times x minus 3, and then we are going to add the 1 to it and make this equal to 2. And now just solve it. 2x minus 6 plus 1 is equal to 2. That's negative 5. Add a 5 to both sides, so we will get 2x equals 2 plus 5 is 7, and then divide 2 on both sides, x equals 7 over 2. Just like that. That's it. By the way though, I actually don't know how to handle when you have 3 absolute values in a nice way. If you do know, let me know. I don't think the picture works anymore, unfortunately.